The MSc in Biosocial Medical Anthropology is the first programme of its kind in the UK to bring together biological, social and medical anthropology. It responds to an urgent need to address global healthcare challenges such as epidemics and climate change in relation to the Anthropocene, but also in responding to new and novel areas of science such as epigenetics, human microbiome research, neuroscience, where the social is being reframed in particular kinds of ways in relation to the biological. As a program, provides you the opportunity to cover a number of key areas that we think are relevant to biosocial approaches. In term one of the program, you will develop and understand the theoretical and conceptual tools that we think are necessary to address biosocial developments in mental health, in chronic disease, in thinking about health inequalities, in thinking about biosocial difference around ethnicity and gender, and even aging.
Term two of the biosocial master's degree is really focused on mixed methods training. It's also an opportunity to think about applied aspects of biosocial research and how you might incorporate those biosocial methods into the real world after graduation. To this effect, we think critically about the human relationship to urban environments and urban ecologies. And we get out onto the street actually to see what the health landscapes of the London ecology is. So we might look at things such as food choices and food options across the city, but also access to green spaces, to noise pollution and air pollution, but also places where it's peaceful. And we combine that with neuroscience and psychology to think about how the brain and cognition actually operates in different aspects of the city. So we might think about other changes in the city, policy and government in government interventions that impact upon health in ways we might not expect. For example, we might look at rising rents, changes in uncertainty, economic instability, and the way people move through cities. The dissertation requires our master's students to engage with both qualitative and quantitative methods. To this effect, we give seminars where we purposely mix different methodologies in biosocial anthropology to think through how to model health in the 21st century.
In the aging body seminar, what we were interested in is how these new biomedical technologies are extending our older adults' lives longer than we could ever foretell. And the impact that these biomedical life-extending technologies have on social organizations of older adults and their care, and also how these biomedical technologies are expanding our sense of what is possible in old age. And so conversations about biological plasticity and the impact of social and technological processes on our biological lifespans come up in this seminar as well. I also teach on the aging brain, and what we're interested in is thinking about why it is that Alzheimer's and dementia show up differently across the globe and why that's the case. A lot of doctors talk about having a genetic predisposition to Alzheimer's. And yet the nurses that I worked with during my fieldwork at a retirement community in Los Angeles would say that oftentimes older adults who moved into this retirement community would start to show signs of dementia and Alzheimer's that they probably wouldn't have otherwise. And that was because they were moving away from their family context. They were moving into a strange institution that had different rhythms that they were used to. And so they were really interested in thinking about Alzheimer's, not simply as a biological process, but as a process that is informed and made complicated by social practices and time and place. So a biosocial perspective really allows us to think about Alzheimer's in a way that is a process that's affected by social contexts, political processes, as well as biological processes.
We believe students who complete the MSc in Biosocial Medical Anthropology will have a unique set of skills that will really equip them for a broad range of careers. This includes not only careers in academia, where there are emerging and important areas of science, as such as epigenetics and microbiome research or neuroscience, but also careers in applied healthcare areas such as global health, public health, international development. These are all areas that really require a unique and cross-disciplinary set of skills that this program can provide.